procedural question, because sometimes they'll, like I was asking the guy the question about the circles, I did not understand what he was, so I asked him to repeat it. I wasn't asking him a question specifically about the circles, but I just said, okay, I don't understand, could you say that again, please?
Not to get hung up on semantics, would that be a presentation?
Oh, yeah, so should the planning commission allow to ask questions during their presentation, whether it's the public or staff or the applicant?
If it's a clarifying question or a procedural question, I think it's appropriate that may change something. So again, if you're trying to, we get a lot of times where people just don't speak.
So we can say repeat that, but if we wanted to know, tell us more about
no, that's
X, then
that's
LA,
after.
Is that what we're agreeing on?
Yes.
What do you do when somebody testifies and starts to wonder, whose job is that to bring them back? Is that yours? It's not my
job. Not my job. We can tell them that their time, I could say you're getting close to your time, could you wrap it up?
No, I don't mean time. I'm talking, they start talking about something else other than what's on the agenda.
I understand your question. What we've used in, when I had other positions like chair of boards and stuff, that if they realize they've got a 10-minute window to do their thing, and they walk in and start reading the Constitution to us because they don't think we have control to do that, we made the comment, you've got your 10 minutes. You can tell us anything you want in
your
10 minutes, but don't beg for, we didn't give them what they wanted because they weren't talking about what they wanted.
I don't agree.
I think use the time limit.
You sit next to me and poke me.
No.
Think they're wandering.
That relates to how the planning commission should ask questions. I really worded this question like that. What I meant to say is, like a city commission, they'll go through and each commissioner will ask questions or maybe in deliberations do their deliberations and then they're done and that's it. And they don't speak anymore. It goes one by one, and they also use the button to ask to speak. You don't use the buttons here now in that way. But the general question is, do you guys want to ask questions in a particular order, like left to right, left, or just is it okay if we're working on that?
Yes. These guys they will speak when they need to speak. I don't.
Something somebody else might say will jog something in your mind
right.
That you want to.
The only time I go down the line is when we're getting ready to
wrap up,
you know.
So good segue into deliberations. Deliberations are funny because sometimes you'll speak to applicants while the record is open in a way that sounds like deliberation before you're officially deliberating. So I want to just zero in on that. How do we want deliberations to work? Harry, is there any legal?
There's no requirement or prohibition to deliberating early. I think sometimes it can't be helped because it will be your questions are going to lead to a result that everybody in the public will know where you're headed. I think it's more a question of efficiency than it is a question of whether or not it's legal to deliberate during the proceeding. I think if we're going to try to emphasize efficiency, we want to try to keep the proceeding moving with questions or with public testimony or with a deliberation.
I don't think we've ever had a real issue with deliberation. There's been a couple times when I'm like, okay, you have to say you're safe, what was it relevant to, but it's their turn, it's their time, and so. I don't think the deliberations phase is ever been high enough to compare to as far as
So, and then
go ahead.
I think the issue is either number of agenda items or we will be on 10 o'clock. Because after 10, I'm not ready to make a decision. I get frustrated.
not want this, something like this to be anonymous again.
Oh, we'll talk about it. It's because on the sheet.
No.